want to talk a little bit about your career. Can you tell me about how you got your first agent?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I had been hanging around on CompuServe on the literary forum, it was called back then, and I'd been there for some time when I began to write my first novel. I was not going to tell anyone what I was doing, and I didn't, but some months into it, I was working late one night and logging on periodically. I was having an intermittent conversation, an argument with a gentleman online about what it feels like to be pregnant. And he said, oh, I know what that's like. My wife's had three children. And I laughed and I said, yeah, Buster, I've had three children. He said, can you tell me what it's like? I said, I can, but it's rather complex. I don't think I could fit it in a 30-line message slot. Yes. I said, but I have this piece in which a young woman explains to her brother what it's like to be pregnant. I'll put that in the library for you. So I did, and everyone who'd been reading the argument went and read this piece, too. And they all came rushing back and said, well, this is great. What is it? And I said, I don't know. And they said, where's the beginning? And I said, I haven't written that yet. And they said, well, put up some more of it. So I did. You know, I don't write in a straight line or with an outline, but whenever I would have 5 or 10 pages that would stand alone, I'd put them up, and people got more and more excited. They said, oh, Diana has a new chunk, have you read it? And they talk about it, and they began saying to me, well, you should try to get it published. And I said, I have no idea how, you know, I wasn't intending to show this to anyone, it's a practice book, but you know, for the sake of argument, what should I do? They all said, get a literary agent. Yeah. An agent could get you read much more quickly than sending things to a slush pile, and if it does sell, he or she can negotiate a much better contract than you could do. Yeah. I said, fine, how do you find an agent? Anyway, they gave me a lot of good advice, but part of it boiled down to ask people who have agents.
Yes.
And so I began talking to, I knew a number of published authors at this point, and so I would say, you know, can you tell me about your agent, et cetera, et cetera. And I had begun to do my own research and zeroed in on this one gentleman named Perry Knowlton, who I thought might be a good match for me, but he didn't take unsolicited queries. So I just went on asking questions. And a few months later, I was talking to a friend named John Stith, who writes science fiction mysteries, and I said, well, I'm asking everyone about agents, John, have you got one? He said, yes, by coincidence, it's the same as so-and-so's. His name is Perry Knowlton. He said, I know you're almost ready to look for an agent. Would you like me to recommend you to him?
Wow.
And I said, that would be great, John. So I was afraid John would be run over by a bus or leave CompuServe before I finished the book, so I said, yes, go ahead, ask him. So he sent Perry a note saying I was worth looking at. I followed that with my own query, and I said, dear Mr. Knowlton, I've been writing and selling nonfiction by myself, but I understand I need good representation for novels, which I'm working on now. Said, I have a very long historical novel. I don't want to waste your time. Would you be willing to read excerpts from it? I didn't tell him excerpts were all I had. I hadn't finished the book. And he kindly called back and said, yes, he'd read my excerpts. So I hastily wrote a 26-page single-space synopsis, sent it with my bundle of excerpts, and he took me on the basis of an unfinished first novel.
That is an amazing story. That's exactly what we were looking for.
Okay.
In that story, you mentioned a little bit about the way that you write. So tell me a little bit about the way that you write. Do you sit down every day and say you're going to write 10 pages?
You do try to write every day, because if you don't, then the inertia builds up on you and it's very hard to start again. Early in a book, I won't know much about the book and I will be doing a lot of research, so I will write every day, but it may only be half a page or a page. And then as I get my bearings, so to speak, I'll move up. And my walking pace, as I call it, is about 1,000 words a day, which is 2 single-space pages. If I make that, it's a good day, and you know, some days I make more. But I always aim for that. And then toward the end of a book, when I know everything, and it's just how long can I sit at the computer before I fall over? So I may be working 15 hours a day straight.
And lots of coffee, right?
Diet Coke.
Diet Coke.
Yeah, I'm actually allergic to coffee.
The last thing I want to ask you is a little bit about maybe some of the setbacks and rejection you maybe have had in the field as a writer. So can you tell me about maybe one story that maybe you were discouraged about and what you would give advice someone else on to get over it or to kind of to get over the hurdles they may have?
I'm probably the wrong person to ask about this because I've never actually been rejected in terms of
that's great.
Of novels and things like that. Now, the closest I've come was in the late 70s. I had been reading comic books ever since my mother taught me to read at the age of 3, using those, and one day I was reading one and said, well, this is pretty bad, I bet I could do better myself. So I found out the name and address of the editor, wrote him this very rude letter. It said, dear sir, I've been reading your comics for 25 years, they've been getting worse and worse. I said, I'm not sure I could do better myself, but I'd like to try. Well, he luckily had a sense of humor. He wrote back and said, okay, try. Well, and he showed me the format in which to submit a script. I did, and he did not buy it, so that was my first and I think my only rejection. But he did something much more valuable. He told me what was wrong with it. He did buy my second story, which is my first fiction sale ever, and I continued to write for him for the next 3 years until the Disney people said, we've got 40 years of Carl Barks stories in the files. Why are we buying new ones? So that was the end of my comics
career.
That
is amazing. Thank you so much for telling that story with us. Thank you so much.
My pleasure.
Thanks a lot.